Remember, we were sinners before. Hallelujah. Due to what Eden did in the beginning, in the Garden of Eden. But because of the love of God that he gave willingly, the love that he did not withhold, the love he gave wholeheartedly, hallelujah, we now have the access of his kingdom. We are now called his sons. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, as the sons of God, remember, when people see a child behaving, they will not say this child is like this, but they will say the family is like that. Hallelujah. So as the sons of God, when we do not love, it questions our sonship. Hallelujah. It questions what kind of sons are we. Because here John says, what kind of love? It means it's not an ordinary kind of love. Hallelujah. Because when you read it in King James, it says in what manner? It means this person is in awe of what they are observing or what they are seeing. Hallelujah. Or the information that is at their disposal. Hallelujah. When you read the very same chapter, I'm going to read verse 11. It says, for this is the message that you have heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. Hallelujah. Now, it says this is the message which you have heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. Hallelujah. So it means that when salvation was brought to us, it introduced love. Because that is where our life begins. Hallelujah. Because when the Bible says that if a man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Everything has been made brand new. Hallelujah. All things have passed away. It means the previous life, we don't count it, we don't even talk about it. But we talk of the life that we're living after receiving Christ. Now here it says that, for this is the message that we have heard from the beginning, that we should love one another. Hallelujah. So it means that the salvation that God brought into our life, the salvation that he gave us, introduced love. Hallelujah. It gave us the love of God. And now the love of God, it's not selfish. Hallelujah. It does not withhold, but it gives. Hallelujah. So it means I will never curse somebody because they curse me. That is not love. Hallelujah. Christ, I remember the scripture that says, Christ is here, they say, love those who love and hate your enemies. But I say, love those who also hate you. That is the kind of love that Christ introduces. Hallelujah. Here, the Bible says, what is there if you do, maybe you are kind to other people because they are kind to you, but for those who are not kind to you, are not kind to them, and what reward is there for you? Hallelujah. Simply saying that as the child of God, you do not love a person because they love you back, but you love because you have God inside of you. Hallelujah. You love because you are a child of God. It is your nature. Hallelujah. It is who God is, and because you are like God, as the Bible says, as he is, so are we. Because God loved us when we didn't even want to be associated with him, it means that we have the ability to love even those who hate us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Verse 16, it says, by this we know love, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brothers. But if anyone has the world's goods and sees his brother in need, yet closes his heart against him, how does God's love abide in him? Hallelujah. It's a question. Little children, let us not love in word or in talk, but in deed and in truth. Hallelujah. Here, it outlined again what we read before. Hallelujah. It says that we know love. Hallelujah. We didn't hear about love, but we know love. Hallelujah. It means it's something that is a first-hand experience, something that we know. Hallelujah. We didn't hear about it, but we know of it. Hallelujah. That God laid down his life for us. Hallelujah. So it means since we are like God, we need to reciprocate that which God has done. Hallelujah. Meaning that we need to lay down our lives for our brothers. Hallelujah. Because rather in need and enclose yourself. You don't give to them. It raises a question. It says, how does God's love abide in him? Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Remember, I said that the love of God, it gives. It is not selfish. It does not withhold, and it gives the best. Hallelujah. Amen. So when you love your brother, because verse 18 it says, let us not love in word or in talk, but in deed and in truth. Hallelujah. Amen. So the love of God is not just like a matter of me saying it, but it's a matter of me showing it. Hallelujah. Amen. You show the love of God. Hallelujah. Amen. If you see me in need and you have the ability to help me and you let me suffer, it questions the kind of love that you possess, or if you possess any kind of love. Hallelujah. Amen. Because God gave. He is a perfect example of what love is ought to be. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. So because we are his sons, it's like a prince in a palace. However way he behaves, he learns from his father, the king. Hallelujah. Amen. So if we say that we are of God, that we are born again, that we are like God, but we fail to show love, as the Bible says that God is love. It says, how can you say you love a God whom you do not see, but you fail to love your brother whom you can see with your eyes? Hallelujah. It's a question also. So this means that it needs one to look into themselves, examine their lives, examine their way of doing things, and see if they really possess the love of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because love, it's something that, I don't know how to call it, but when you love, you never wish anything bad for the one you love. Hallelujah. You will never hurt them intentionally so. Hallelujah. You will do your utmost best, your all, to ensure that those you love are cared for. Hallelujah. So if you see a brother suffering and you say, let him be, it's like, I think it's 1 Peter 2, which says that if you see me, the one that is talking about faith, that if you see me suffering and you say, God be with you, but you are able to help me, you have food, you have clothes, you can pray for me, you can see that I'm struggling with something, you can pray for me, but you choose not to, then it questions the love of God in you. Hallelujah. It questions if you really do love God, if you really do possess the love of God, and if you really do love the person next to you, the person that you're sitting next to right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As the children of God, because we love, we do not, because somebody has done something wrong to me, we don't do an eye for an eye. We don't do that. Remember, the Bible says we are the light of the world and the salt of the earth. Hallelujah. So if you are the light and you behave like the darkness, it questions if you really are the light. Hallelujah. I love it when it says, what use is there for a salt if it has lost its saltiness? It says the only thing to do is just to throw it and people trample upon it. Hallelujah. So as the light of the world, as people that possess the love of God, it means that we need to show the love of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It means that we need to show that we are different. There's a scripture that says the disciples were asking Christ, Lord, how will the world recognize that we are yours? The answer was simple. When you love one another. Hallelujah. The answer was simple. When you love one another, the world will recognize that you are mine. Because the kind of love you will be able to show it, it's very different to how the world portrays love or defines love. Hallelujah. 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 The love of God, it considers others first. Hallelujah. Remember, None of us deserved the kindness of God, the grace of God. But God, because he wanted a relationship with us, he said, let me give my best to the world so that I can have a relationship with mankind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So when we love, we give our best. Hallelujah. In chapter 4, verse 8, verse John, verse 7, it says, beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God. And whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. Hallelujah. Anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love. Hallelujah. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world, so that we might live through him. In this is love. Not that we have loved God, but he loved us and had sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us and his love is perfected in us. Hallelujah. By showing the love of God, it becomes perfect. I'll give a practical example. For you to, let's say somebody is a dancer, for them to perfect their craft, it means they need to constantly practice. They need to constantly practice. So for the love of God in us, because we didn't know it before we were born again, the kind of love that God has given to us, for us to fully show it and indeed perfect it, it means we need to do it daily. Hallelujah. It means that we need to show love all the time. Even when it's challenging, we allow ourselves to die. Whatever thing I might feel towards the person, I choose not to say. Because the scripture in the Bible which says, we know that the opposite of love is hate. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And it also says, the scripture says that the righteousness of God is not revealed when you are angry. Because remember, when you are angry, you will say the most hateful things because you are feeling pain, you are angry. Hallelujah. But when we choose to not allow our feelings to dictate how we relate to people, then we will be able to perfect the love of God. Hallelujah. When we follow God's command, the love of God in us becomes perfected. Hallelujah. The love of God in us becomes complete. Hallelujah. Because of God abides in us. Remember, the Bible says, I will abide in you and you abide in me. That is Christ in John 15. Hallelujah. For us to bear the fruit of the Spirit, which love is not there. Hallelujah. We need to abide in Christ and Christ abides in us. Hallelujah. How do we abide in Christ? It means that we need to know what the Word is saying. We need to know who we are in God. We need to also show it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even if somebody does not appreciate the love you show to them, you don't stop doing it. Hallelujah. You continuously do it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I know it might be challenging, but one thing I have learned is, if we learn as the children of God to let go and let God, that is when things happen. Hallelujah. When we learn to let go and let God, because that would mean that we allow God to use us as he pleases. Hallelujah. I believe Apostle Paul, when he said for me to live is Christ and to die is gain, this is a man that had given his life wholeheartedly to Christ. And men were chosen to do whatever the word of God is saying they must do. Whatever God releases and says you must do this. This is a man that did that. Hallelujah. So the love of God in us is perfected when we do what God says we should do. Hallelujah. When we react, however way God says we should react. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Another thing is the love of God, it redeems. Hallelujah. It gives life. We have received life through the love. As the children of God, we do not condemn. Hallelujah. It means Hallelujah. Because we need to show that we are different. Hallelujah. Which means we encourage. When you encourage somebody, somebody who felt like giving up, when you encourage them, you give them life in some way. Hallelujah. That is how you also show love. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going back to the same book of First John. I'm going to read chapter 1, verse 15 and 16. It says, do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the desires of the flesh and the desires of the eyes and pride of life, is not from the Father, but is from the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Also, we are required to not love the world. And what I love about this is it gives indications, hallelujah, of what, when we say we love the world, what is it that we will be doing? Hallelujah. In verse 17, it says, it speaks of the desires of the flesh when we pursue those things. Hallelujah. The desires of the eyes and the pride of life. Hallelujah. When a man has pride, it's a person who feels that they are independent of God. Hallelujah. It's a man who feels that they can manage by themselves. They don't really need God. Hallelujah. That is pride. Hallelujah. So when we do such things, it means we love the world. And the love of God is not in us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But when we love God, it means such things we will stay away from. Such things we will not even entertain. Hallelujah. Get me there. I'm not saying that we don't get faced with temptations. Hallelujah. I love in E.K. James when you read Romans 8 verse 1. It says, therefore there is no condemnation for them when Christ Jesus. It says, those who do not gratify the desires of the flesh. Hallelujah. Here my main point here is the gratification of the desires of the flesh. Right? You might be tempted. Hallelujah. Just because you fell into temptation does not mean you don't love God. Hallelujah. But the matter here is what is in your heart. Hallelujah. What is in your heart will determine whether or not you love God. Hallelujah. If in your heart what you want is the things that are of the world and of God, then you will say that you love the world. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If in your heart all you want to see is, I'm not saying being rich is wrong, but you are want to acquire wealth at whatever cost they need, then it questions if you have the love of God. Hallelujah. When we love God, it means we also give him our best. This thing, you know, love is reciprocal. I show you love, you show me love. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because God has loved us, we need to show him back. Hallelujah. You might be showing it back by taking care of others. Hallelujah. Showing God that God, we love you and we are showing your love to others. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As well as you God. Hallelujah. So love of God requires us to refuse defining ourselves. Hallelujah. We need to refuse defining ourselves. We need to choose God first above all. Hallelujah. We need to choose God first. There are people who have had testimonies that they were kicked out of their families because they got born again. Hallelujah. They chose to leave the comfortability that they were used to for the sake of God. Hallelujah. When you love God, you will defend the gospel of Christ. Hallelujah. You do not speak better because your friends are not born again, but but you defended to show love back to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Since I don't have enough much time left, I'm going to ask us to stand. Hallelujah. We are going to pray, hallelujah, that God let your love be reflected in us, hallelujah. If I know that there were certain things that I was doing and they did not show the love of God, then it means it's time for me to change, hallelujah. Because this message is not just for you guys, it's also for me to change and be like God, hallelujah. See me, when my family sees me, they see the love of God in me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we are going to pray that God help us to show your love. Teach us how to love. If you don't know how to love, teach us how to love. Hallelujah. Your kind of love, not the love of the world, but the God kind of love. Hallelujah. And we say, Lord, may your love be perfected in us, hallelujah. And another thing that will help us with the love of God to be perfected is knowing the way of doing that which it says. Hallelujah. When we follow his commands, when God speaks, we listen and we do, then the love of God becomes perfected in us. Hallelujah.